You're listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard. Glad that you could join us today. Our guest is Dr. Barry Jacobson. He's a board-certified Crozer Keystone gynecologist, one of the leading physicians in the area of bone health and osteoporosis. And as such, he's joining us on the program today to talk about osteoporosis, some of the gaps in treatment, and a newly approved FDA treatment for postmenopausal women. Welcome to Health Professional Radio, Dr. Barry Jacobson. How are you today?
Good. Nice to be here.
Great, great. Well, give our listeners a bit of background about your practice and some of the patients that you see on a regular basis.
Sure. I started osteoporosis back in 97, so I've been doing it for 20 years. Mm-hmm. I have 7 osteoporosis outpatient centers. Okay. So that's patients being referred to me with abnormal DEXA scans or fractures. Mm-hmm. I also run a fracture program in 4 hospitals, so we see about 500 patients a year in the hospital who have acute fractures, mm-hmm. To try to get them treated because they're the most severe of the bone disease.
So most of our listeners are healthcare professionals. What is osteoporosis in a nutshell?
Well, osteoporosis is a disease of bone strength, which leads to increased fragility fractures. Bone strength is a combination of bone quantity, which we measure with a DEXA scan, and bone quality, which unfortunately we can't measure with a DEXA scan, unfortunately. Many people have fractures, which by definition also makes them osteoporotic. So the definition of osteoporosis, besides the clinical definition, is a DEXA scan number of minus 2.5, which is a X-ray to look at your bones in the spine and the hip, sometimes the forearm. The other definition is a fragility fracture, which is defined as a fracture over 50, male or female, to somebody who falls from upright or below, and if they break their wrist, their ankle, ribs, spine, humerus, pelvis, or hip, that is a fragility fracture. There are patients who can have low bone mass, or we used to call osteopenia, on DEXA scan, but once they have a fragility fracture, they're by definition osteoporotic.
Now, you mentioned both men and women, or women and men. Who's most at risk? We are going to talk about menopausal women, so I guess osteoporosis does.
Yeah, women are most at risk. Okay. Women are 90% of osteoporosis patients, although they're not 90% of fracture patients. So, you know, the plug I always make is men should get DEXA scans because they're the forgotten sex when it comes to bone loss. But women are more commonly diagnosed because a lack of estrogen at menopause will automatically lead to bone loss physiologically.
Does osteoporosis automatically guarantee fractures?
No, it does not. Osteoporosis, if you're osteoporotic, well, let's go back. A woman at age 50 will have a 50% chance of fracturing in their lifetime, regardless of DEXA scan. If they have a DEXA scan with osteoporosis, we can state that there's a 50% chance of fracturing in the next 5 years. So that's the number. Unfortunately, again, people who have low bone mass or osteopenia also are at risk for fracture as they age for the reason that bone quality can't be measured.
So what are the traditional treatments for osteoporosis?
Well, the traditional treatments that came back in the 1990s are drugs called bisphosphonates, and they come 3 oral bisphosphonates and 1 intravenous. And they're called anti-resorptive therapies. They prevent further loss to stabilize bones. And they're excellent drugs with excellent data. The biggest issue with them, especially the oral drugs, are compliance. Compliance in taking a pill once a month or once a week, which have special instructions, approximately 30 to 40%. So conversely, 60 to 70% of people who take those drugs within a year are off or taking them incorrectly. So that's the problem with the most commonly used drugs. There are other anti-resorptive therapies in the market. The ideal treatment for bone loss or fractures is to build bone. Drugs called anabolic therapy, which don't inhibit bone resorption. They actually stimulate bone growth.
So would you say that that is the only gap in treatment of a person's compliance issues over time? An obvious huge gap in treatment from some of these traditional treatments. There are some new treatments, I'm sure, that address compliance issues as well as others. Let's talk about this newly FDA-approved treatment for osteoporosis in postmenopausal women.
Got it. So you're talking about TYMLOS, or the generically called abaloparatide, which is a PTH molecule. It's actually PTH-related protein, which is a hormone in your body already, which given subcutaneously on a daily basis actually builds bone. And again, compliance is really with that drug, because people are injecting themselves on a daily basis, people who take it are really motivated because they know why they're taking it. They know that the compliance is important to decrease fracture risk by a dramatic amount, especially if they had a previous fracture.
So being an injection, a self-injection of that, you know, compliance issues are a factor, I'm sure. So what type of patient is an ideal candidate for TYMLOS?
Well, ideally, a patient who's had a fracture, which is obviously the worst of osteoporosis, would be always a candidate for anabolic therapy with TYMLOS. And they would be very motivated because they've always had a fracture. There are also people who have osteoporosis who've been on other medication and failed, have gotten worse. They're also great candidates to build bone. And again, the key to TYMLOS is the conversation around what it's doing, building bone versus preventing loss, and the fracture risk associated with osteoporosis, which is gigantic, and the dramatic decrease in fractures associated with building bone. With that conversation, we find that compliance tends to be really, really good. Even though it's a daily injection, it's a 31-gauge needle. You can barely feel it. It takes 25, 30 seconds a day from start to finish. And people tolerate it really well. And insurance coverage, as we've gotten into osteoporosis more and more, has gotten better and better. In commercially insured patients, your out-of-pocket expense is $4 a month, which is really inexpensive for a biological agent.
Where can we go and learn some more about this?
Well, again, most physicians will have sales reps from Radius, which is Radius Health, which makes abaloparatide or TYMLOS. Again, most primary care guys have some referral base to some endocrinologists or rheumatologists or somebody like myself, osteoporosis centers, who deal with these drugs every day. There are CMEs. There's actually programs around, promotional programs that drug companies do to educate doctors about bone loss. They're all available for the primary care world to try to get comfortable with the injection process and the benefits of TYMLOS in building bone.
Great, great. Dr. Jacobson, it's been a pleasure. Thank you so much for joining us here on the program today.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard. Join us at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au. Subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in, and download at SoundCloud. And visit our affiliates page on our platform at hpr.fm.